Welcome back. I'm Mark Barton, live from London. You're watching Countdown here on Bloomberg. Now, if you'd sold your business to Warren Buffett for $4 billion, you'd be forgiven for taking things easy. But Eitan Wertheimer, the 61-year-old chairman of Iscar, isn't about to put his feet up. Bloomberg's Elliott Gotkine caught up with the billionaire Israeli. He was given rare access to Iscar's factories, should I say, in northern Israel.
If you're making a car or building a plane, precision cutting tools are a must. They might well come from here, Iscar's flagship factory in northern Israel, one of 15 such plants worldwide.
This is the part of the manufacturing process where the inserts for Iscar's cutting tools are made. These are the bits that do the actual cutting. They're made out of tungsten carbide, a material that's as strong as diamond.
Almost as robust is the business itself. Analysts estimate revenues at almost $2 billion, less than half market leader Sandvik of Sweden, but more than America's Kennametal.
You made it through the doors.
I know. Iscar's chairman is coy when it comes to numbers. This is, after all, a subsidiary of Berkshire Hathaway. But when we met in November, he didn't appear too concerned by a slowing global economy or growing competition from China.
Business is very different than last year. Last year we had a very wild growth, was crazy. We hardly could hold up in that speed. And this year it's a little more relaxed, so we have time to get ourselves organized and put all pieces in place.
Iscar's technology and bespoke tools will help, but its 11,000 workers are just as important. The company didn't lay off a single one during the financial crisis, and it has one asset in particular that nobody else can match.
The number one salesperson for Iscar, for IMC actually, is Mr. Buffett. That's the only way I convinced him to come with us to India or to all kind of places. I told him the most important sales and marketing element that we have in the whole company. And when you go with him around the world, it's like magic.
Wertheimer hopes the Sage of Omaha's sorcery can help double the business. But to be number one, it would have to grow even bigger.
Sandvik now has fully bought one of the holdings it had called Seco. And with that, it now has more than 20% market share globally. Iscar probably has around 7-8%, so they would, need to more than double, and Sandvik need to be stable for that to happen. So I think it's quite unlikely that they can be number one.
Unrealistic, perhaps, but maybe not impossible. After all, Iscar was founded in a rented shack in these hills 60 years ago. Look where it is now. Elliott Gotkine, Bloomberg, Tefen, Northern Israel.
And if you're wondering what Eitan and his family did after selling to Warren Buffett, he tells us they gathered together the names of everyone who'd ever worked at Iscar and gave them all a big present as a thank you.